how do we assess looks or good looks? There is a difference between it. Jupiter, Moon, and Surya are planets, you know, which define good looks. But again, each one has got a different sort of a advice to give. For example, Jupiter will give you attractive looks, or for that matter, you are intellectually very attractive. Why? Because people find you as Jupiter. They want to seek advice from you. All those things are associated with Jupiter. Hello and namaste, and thank you so much for visiting my channel. My name is Karthik Gaur, and please do subscribe and click the bell icon to ensure that whenever we upload a webinar or a video, you are the first ones to know. Thank you so much. Now let us understand the sound advice. Okay, here I have given two types of complexion, and sometimes both these complexion can be there in a human being. I remember when I met a film star long time back, and you know, he was pretty like almost dark brown. And then we lost touch, and after like 5-6 years, he again, you know, we met, and suddenly he was extremely like fair. Like, means we would say wheatish, you know. So there was a huge transition. And he had moved between dashas, and the dasha was absolutely different to the last time when we met. And the first thing that I told him, that wow, you know, you are in a different dasha altogether, and there's something positive which is happening. And he said that yes, I'm actually doing a lot of Ayurveda and basically drinking a lot of kada and all those things, as a result of which I'm able to change my skin tone. So you understand, he went into this, Mercury and Jupiter were together, and he went into that dasha, as a result of which Mercury is all about Ayurveda, green leaf, leafy vegetable, you know, eating organic, those stuff all are in that sort of a thing, vegan, all those things come under that sort of an umbrella. So what I mean to say that a complexion will tell you which is the planet which is dominating. And complexion has to be seen in Rashi and Navamsha, or the impact of a planet on Rashi Lagna as well as Navamsha Lagna. Very, very important. You know, why Navamsha? Because Navamsha is a past life. And sometimes there are certain people who are having a full life based on Navamsha only. Okay. In a way, it means that their life is on a recording. Their life is just a recording which is being played. As a result of which, you know, almost everything that they do doesn't have a positive impact or a negative impact, at least as yet. So a lot of time people complain that, hey, this person is doing so much of ugly karmas. You know, why is karma not taking a sort of a revenge on him? And why is it that this person is still enjoying all the good things in life? Probably because he has come with a great traveler's check. As a result of which, you know, the person is so happy. The person is actually able to overcome a lot of his negative karmas based on the savings with which he is going to come. Similarly, a complexion is also an inheritance. Okay, so this is something which is important. Now, how do we assess looks or good looks? There is a difference between it. Jupiter, Moon, and Surya are planets, you know, which define good looks. But again, each one has got a different sort of a advice to give. For example, Jupiter will give you attractive looks, or for that matter, you are intellectually very attractive. Why? Because people find you as Jupiter. The way you speak, the quantum of knowledge that you have, or you can almost debate in every topic, you know, it is just that purely Jupiterian pull, you know, which attracts other people. You know, that out of the 100 people in that room, they want to come and talk to you. They want to come and approach you. They want to spend some time with you. They want to seek advice from you. All those things are associated with Jupiter. whereas Chandra looks is more like a sex appeal, that oomph factor, you know, that, oh my goodness, you know, this girl or guy looks so hot, you know. So moon is more of that sexual appeal, that, oh, I wish I could do this, oh, I wish. So it's more in those things, right? Chandra is more of possession. Your mind is being captivated. Whereas Surya is pure personality, you know, where certain people have just that great personality. When they walk into the room, you know, they sort of, a lot of heads turn. Why? Because they are 6 feet tall, you know, strong voice, you know, the nice posture, you know, nice suit. Everything about them is so perfect. It is purely Surya. You look at them, you feel like it's a king. Yeah? Can you say Amitabh Bachchan has got more of that Surya sort of a personality? Where when he dresses up, when he enters, when he sort of speaks, you know, he has got that great attribute. Or that image of being a leader. You understand? The second in the rank is Venus and Mercury. But Venus and Mercury are again something, you know, which is coming because of Rajas. Oh, wow, you know, that person has a great, he always wears an Armani suit. Okay, he always, his watch is brilliant. You have seen that Rolex watch in his hand. It looks so good. Or look at that lady, you know, she always has this best of Burberry purses or this best of watches, or, you know, look at her sari, you know, she is always so well dressed, and, you know, she has a stylist. So everything around, you know, your looks, or everything around your wealth, or an aura around you, you know, which creates your beautification. You know, you come out of a good car, you know, everything around that is Venus, very beautiful. But that Rajas part plays a major part in terms of that attraction. Mercury is attraction by speech, by sense of humor. That, oh, this guy is so funny, you know, I love him. You know, something like that. Whereas Mangal and Shani are not in contention for looks. They agree that, hey, we are not those so-called studs or babes or whatever you call it, right? So they are more in terms of, they say that, you know, hey, we are not competing, you know, that's why we are very secluded. That's why Shani is more of an extrovert. Why? Because it is too conscious about itself. You know, it feels that, you know, oh, I'm too short, you know, should I wear a heel, or I've seen some guys who wear heels to look tall, you know, because somewhere inside they have a psyche that I'm not that tall. So Shani and Mangal sort of give a little bit of stunted sort of a look. Whereas the other five planets give sort of great sort of looks in their respective domain. Okay. Now, Mangal, within Shani and Mangal, Mangal is one which gives a short height. Okay. By default itself is short. But the problem with Shani is Shani gives you this hunchback. Or let's say your posture is not good. You know, you see certain people, you know, they sit like this. Or, you know, generally while they're sitting, you know, their shoulders have dropped. And slowly, 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 you know, they have almost become the tortoise, you know. That's why it is called as hunchback. You know, so there is a part of their height which has come down, as a result of which they look shorter than what they are. Okay. Whereas Shani can stretch the body, you know, Shani in Lagna, good height. I've got, Surya. Surya in Lagna is super height. I've got Surya in Lagna. I'm 6 feet high. You understand? But I have also Shani aspecting the Lagna. So to that level, I have to take care with my posture. There are times when I'm working, my posture can droop a little. Then I have to again focus myself. You know, hey, sit properly, otherwise you'll have a back pain. You understand? So very important. Whereas node put an aura around them, where they look darker. Nodes are Rahu and Ketu. Okay, and sometimes they can give a very colorless sort of a appearance, which means that a person looks like a ghost. The person is so fair, almost no blood, you know, and you feel that, you know, that that person is either having a disease, right? And that is what the nodes do. Nodes put an aura around it. So either you start looking darker, but you are not actually dark. But it is just that it gives you a little bit of a pale look, you know, a little bit of, you know, that aura where that there is no shine which is there. Okay. And this is seen, again I'm repeating, from the stronger among the Rashi and Navamsha. Always start with the Navamsha first. And that's why, you know, sometimes, you know, when somebody does a consultation for their child who is too small, then when the child is too small, frankly speaking, I don't have much sort of things to fall back on apart from their father and mother. In that case, you know, I always ask for the photo of the child. Just to see the complexion, just to see which are the prominent parts in his face. Is his nose beautiful, or is his eyes beautiful, or his ears are bigger? You know, depending on that, I can do the rectification. Okay, so it's very interesting that, you know, we can use such minute details to actually rectify the chart also. Okay. Namaste Jyotisha lovers, thank you so much for viewing the video. Please do share so more and more thirsty souls can benefit from this free knowledge which is being shared. Also do subscribe, click the bell icon, and all the questions that you have, please mention in the comment section below. Thank you so much, and please keep supporting us.